So now we're looking at lumbar disc herniation. And the exercise that we want to show is the floppy push-up. And what that is doing is looking at centralizing the disc to minimize the signs and symptoms that your client is experiencing. So with the floppy push-up, there's two variations that you can do, one to put progress on top of the other. So the first one is as you're lying down, you get them to tuck their elbows in underneath them. Hands are going to be face down, and then you're just going to lift up onto your elbows. And what that's going to do is going to put that pressure into the low back to help centralize that disc. You want to hold that for starting with 5 seconds up to a minute based on your signs and symptoms and how it relieves the signs and symptoms of your client. So as you hold, and then once you've done that, you're just going to slowly come back down and then you'll complete the exercise. So this is an exercise you can do several times a day as a relief for the signs and symptoms, but also as a preventative measure to help the symptoms from coming back. As a progression, once it gets better or you're looking at doing more, you can come up, get the hands underneath, and you can push up onto the hands, which it, you put more pressure on the low back, but it also is, as the body allows, allowing for more centralization to occur. The other part is if the disc is protruding one side more than the other, you can add a movement to either laterally, left or right, to help with that centralization. So as you come up to your elbows, you can make a turn to your left if you're looking at centralizing it back that way, which will help with that centralization of the disc. And again, holding for 5 to up to a minute, depending on your signs and symptoms. So when you're getting your client to run through the floppy push-up, you can get them lying down. Again, this is an exercise you can do on the ground. You can do it on your bed. Purposes here, we're on the table. So lying down, face down. What they're going to do for, on the elbows, we're going to start with. The elbows are going to tuck in underneath them, and they're going to lift themselves up onto their elbows. And what that's going to do is going to put that pressure in on the low back, which is going to help to centralize that disc. So what we can do with that variation, if it's protruding one side more than the other, we can, you can have your client move themselves to the one side. So we can have our client move to the left, which is going to help to push it back into that center. And again, we're looking at holding this for 5, 15, up to a minute based on the signs and symptoms that the client is feeling and experiencing in order to try to reduce those. As you come back to the middle, you can bring yourself back down. Then we look at doing the second variation, which is becomes more advanced. We're looking at more relief and more ability on the client as well as coming up onto the hands. So now the hands come underneath, and they lift right up onto their hands. And again, that's going to further increase the pressure on the low back, looking at that centralization of that disc, which is going to help with that lumbar disc herniation.
So when a client has a disc herniation, one of the positions they will assume is a lateral shift, which, depending on which side the disc is protruding from, they will assume as a protective mode away from the protrusion in order to reduce the pain. So their upper body will be shifted over and their lower body will stay in that position. So can either be from one side or the other, depending on what the protrusion is from. What you can do as a therapist, you can correct the client if they're coming in with a shift. You can have them start off by placing your one hand on their hip and one hand on the ribcage, this way, and just gently pushing them, encouraging them to have this correct posture. Now, it may be more difficult depending on the spasm and what pain they're feeling. So be very cautious with that and just try and straighten them up very gently. And as well, you can teach the client to do that for themselves. So you can have them place their hands on them, on their body, on the rib cage and on the hip, and gently encourage their own correction. So the client may come in and they may have the upper body shifted to one side or the other. What you can do is do a correction and do it very gently, as I said, just in terms of their pain level and tolerance. So you place one hand on the rib cage and then the other hand on the hip and gently encourage them to come to that correct posture. And as a home exercise, you can also teach your client that as well. So I'll have them turn around. And we'll go into that shift again. So what you can do is have the client place one hand on the rib cage and one hand on their hip and gently push themselves back into a correct position. That'll help